In this video, I'm going to share with you my 6 top tips to get rid of pimples and acne. And by the way, please watch to the very end because the last few tips you are never told about. Let's dive straight to tip number 1. You might not have heard of this one before, but did you know that your pillowcase might be one of the culprits for your pimples or acne? So picture this: dead skin cells, oil, and bacteria accumulating on your pillowcase, which then make your pimples and acne worse, okay? So get into a routine of trying to change your pillowcase to a fresh one every day or at least every other day, and get into a routine of washing them all weekly and continually recycling. Diving straight on to tip number 2, keep it clean. I know it's basic, but it's often overlooked. Wash your face twice a day, morning and nighttime. Don't use excessively hot water, it's gonna dry the skin, make things worse. And don't excessively scrub, it's just gonna cause inflammation again, make things worse. It's all about being gentle with lukewarm water. Diving straight into tip number 3, retinoids. These are a game changer when it comes to pimples or acne treatment. Why? Because they decrease pore obstruction, they decrease inflammation, they decrease oil production, which is fantastic, whilst increasing skin cell turnover. All in all, it's gonna help with the pimples and acne. I really cannot recommend them enough. But here's the most important thing, don't just use any old topical retinoid. If you're watching this video in the US, I will leave a link in the description below for a topical retinoid that I use personally myself, and is FDA approved for the treatment of acne, which means you can buy it over the counter. Link in the description. Let's dig into tip number 4, watch your diet. This doesn't mean you have to stop all your favorite treats, but if your diet is high in high glycemic foods, so for example, refined carbohydrates like French fries, lots of pasta, lots of bread, all this sort of stuff, it can potentially make your pimples and acne worse. So opt for a healthy, balanced diet. That's the most important thing. Let's dig into tip number 5. When it comes to moisturizers, creams, cosmetics, always go for non-comedogenic or non-acnegenic. It should say that on the actual product. This basically means it's not going to clog the pores, which is going to make your pimples and acne worse. So next up, let's talk about these LED face masks and acne. We're all starting to see them more and more. This one in my hand is actually the anti-blemish LED light therapy face mask by CurrentBody. It helps reduce redness, control oil production, calm irritated skin, and reduce shine. And this model actually works by emitting 2 wavelengths. So you have the blue 415 nanometer and the red 633 nanometer. So I guess the next question is, how does it actually work? Well, the blue wavelengths are actually really good at targeting blemish-causing bacteria, so it can be really helpful for those with acne. And the red wavelengths actually target the blemishes more effectively than the blue light by reducing inflammation and reducing redness. And they are 100% safe, pain-free, without the risk of overexposure. You use it for 10 minutes, 3 to 5 days a week. Easy as that. And I personally love using the CurrentBody products. To learn more about CurrentBody, I'm gonna leave a link in the description. Definitely do check them out. And don't forget to use my discount code as well to save hundreds. I'm gonna leave that in the description as well. Best of all, if you're not 100% satisfied, they have a 60-day money-back guarantee. CurrentBody, thank you for being our trusted sponsor. Let's dig into tip number 6, sun protection, okay? If you're regularly getting exposure to sun, it can damage the skin, cause inflammation, and make acne worse. So you need to be using a sunscreen every single day, SPF 30, and it should have 5-star UVA protection. This is super important, okay? Also, if you don't do this, it could eventually cause hyperpigmentation as well and dark spots, okay? If you do suffer from hyperpigmentation and dark spots, I do have a video on it, which I will leave a link to down in the description or on my YouTube channel. Definitely check it out. But don't just go for any old sunscreen. If you're watching this video in the United States, the UK, or Canada, I will leave a link in the description below to a sunscreen that I personally use myself. It's very light, very easy to apply, and best of all, it doesn't leave your eyes stinging like traditional sunscreens can do.